Hello, hello. I am Alessandra Giglioli. I am the Galactic Shaman, or a Galactic Shaman, also working on being a consciousness engineer and a spiritual activist. I'm really excited and I'm really nervous because I'm bringing in a new frequency and it's coming in many ways that we can all access it. The frequency that I'm bringing in is the Galactic Medusa, the new heroine's journey. At this point in time, I am packaging it in a 5-week course. Galactic Medusa. This course is about unearthing hidden history, because the history of humanity has to do with the identity of humans and society. And if we know our identity as humans, then maybe we have a better idea of what we're capable of. So the heroine's journey is really necessary, because right now, flooded in the media, movies, entertainment, everything, we really have the hero's journey. The hero's journey was brought in by Joseph Campbell, and he did a phenomenal job with it. I fell in love with how he spoke about it, and it's accessible to everyone. It touches everyone, the hero's journey. And he got it from comparative mythology and looking at a lot of mythologies around the world. However, they happened all to be male-centered or patriarchal-centered. And there's nothing wrong with the man or man, but societal structure around patriarchy is very confining towards the people that are being colonized and towards women. So the heroine's journey is something that we don't really hear of. There is a whole book on the heroine's journey by Maureen Burdock, and she has many steps. I've gone through a lot of things, as so many of us have, and I've come up with 5 steps for the new heroine's journey. And the heroine's journey is about the divine feminine that is coming back to restore humanity to wholeness. And it's not just for women, it's for the divine feminine in all humans. Big major keys of this new heroine's journey are understanding identity, understanding insanity, going mad, going insane. That also has to do with shamanism or accessing other dimensions within yourself and outside of yourself. There's a lot of things to unpack in this course, but it's really deep and fun, because I am using media literacy language or terminology or tools. Media literacy, nobody knows about it. We know of regular literacy, which is studying the written word. But we are in a screen-heavy world, social media, online, everything. And that has to do with archetypes and communication of who we are as a society and ourselves through images and symbolism, and specifically enforced images that are actually very confining. So media literacy, I think, might fit under sociology, but media literacy is getting literate about the media that we are consuming, and the media that we are consuming on a conscious and subconscious level. So again, there's a lot of stuff to unpack. We've got 5 weeks. We meet 5 times on Zoom Live. And we'll meet for about 3 hours. And there's a beginning, middle, and end to what we do. We will be unpacking the media world that we are in and see how does it inform our psychology? How has it informed our identity as a individual and in our society? So we unpack it, and then we might get a little angry, a little stirred up, and then we go in, and I will lead us in psychosomatic body release so we can move the energy out. And I'm moving with new principles that I've been guided to bring in, which are about emotional alchemy. So we will be really transforming ourselves. Another part of each time we meet, there's a slideshow that I've worked basically 20 years on to bring in hidden history. How was woman seen in the world before mass colonialism, mass conquering of other peoples and rape and pillage of other people? Before that, We have thousands of years, tens of thousand years, 20, 30,000 years of hidden history. And I bring in archaeological things to look at. I'm not here to give answers. I'm here to poke, and trigger for us to then create our own story and our own narrative as we go through the journey, each of the five steps of the new heroine's journey. We also look at mythology, and we look at Medusa. Who is Medusa? And if you can see, it's a digital image that I created, digital collage. Medusa is connected to the Valkyries, connected to the dark aspect of the feminine, which doesn't mean it's bad. It just means that the feminine works with light and dark, understanding the cycles and understanding crop rotation, night and day, when to rest, when not to rest. Patriarchy is more about full throttle, do it till you burn, die, and then just keep going, essentially. And we need even man and masculine needs to be held in the cycles of the divine feminine and the primordial feminine. So we are really unpacking a lot, but it's actually going to be fun. We're going to be able to talk with each other and talk about identity in a safe space. I thought there was something else I was going to say. So we're working with mythology too. At the very end of each day and cycle that we work together, there is some shamanic work. See, okay, with the drum, which helps in release. And then there's high intensity energy heating light. I feel that I transmit the light. I've been trained that way. And I use these incredible sound tools, crystal clear singing bowl, and my new favorite, crystal harp. You can't see, it's rainbowy. Honestly, it looks like a xylophone, but it's called a crystal harp. I don't know if you can hear that. So there's a lot of fun that we're gonna do. And if for any reason or many reasons that people or you are interested and you cannot participate in the first round of this 5-week course, there will be other things available. I will be doing some broadcasts and some free events so that we can get a taste of what Galactic Medusa is bringing to us as a new form of a cohesive goddess or creatrix. Because so many goddesses have been purposely splintered and shoved in their place and given a colonized patriarchal story. The continent of Africa and hidden suppressed people's history, people's identity is also part of the puzzle. So it's about bringing together everybody's culture and identity back online. So that's a lot. I hope I said it all. I have been really working on this for a long time, and it really is my pride and joy. And there's a lot of empowerment. I wrote notes, so let's see if I wrote everything. Actually, I kind of said everything. It's a new frequency to work with. It really gets us to talk about our own narrative to ourselves. And it has to do again with us as an individual, but who are we in? What context are we in now? What are we really being influenced by and how we can empower ourselves? So again, this can be woman-centered, but it's divine feminine-centered. And this can actually be fun, even though it's an intense, heavy topic, but it's packaged so well that we will be feeling freed and excited. And honestly, I have several plot twists each time we meet, which I'm very excited to deliver, which I'm hoping are going to be like mind-blowing information. And the idea is take this and reconstruct yourself as you wish. I'm just here to share, basically have fun, and to bring forward truths, hidden truths, and to really unleash. We're gonna have so much fun. So really unleash and to form a new kind of power. So we're gonna be working also with core personality traits. I'll leave it at that. And let's see if I can close up with, if we can hear the crystal singing bowl. Kuetahie na hai o koho no nei. To me, that was the voice of the goddess creatrix saying, essentially she was saying, oh, I'm going to have fun with you lot. So I guess we're in for more fun. I thought it was going to be heavier, like whoop, but all right. I hope to see you soon. I hope to have links below that have more information about the course, about this energy and frequency and free events. Thank you. Hope to see you soon. Ciao.